Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren.
And I'm Larry.
And in this video, we're going to provide you with a guide to buying home batteries. So Larry, there's a ton of misconceptions out there about batteries, what they can do, how many batteries you need, etc., and how much they cost. Why don't you talk about some of the misconceptions that are out there first?
Yeah, so there's really two main misconceptions. One is that I'm going to install a battery and it's going to back up my whole house. Yeah. That's probably the biggest one that we see. I mean, in reality, one battery is going to back up a few very small loads. The second thing is that it's not going to cost me much. I can back up my house for $5,000.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't even install one battery for $5,000. The smallest battery system that we install is more in the $22,000 to $25,000 range. So those are the two big misconceptions.
What about people who want to use batteries to go off-grid? They may be on-grid, but they think the batteries are going to help them go off-grid, or that they might be completely off-grid and think they want batteries to help them.
Yeah, so there's two main types of battery systems. One is solar with batteries, grid-tied, so you're still connected to the grid, and one is completely off the grid. So completely off the grid, no electrical connection to the electric grid. You can source your power from your solar. Maybe you have a little wind turbine. Maybe you have a generator, some other source of renewable power of some kind, maybe a little water generator, but that's your only sources of power in an off-grid situation. On-grid with battery backup simply means you're still connected to the grid. So when the grid's up, you're getting power from the grid, you're pushing power back to the grid. When the grid is down, that's when your battery system kicks in. And you can still have a generator and other sources of power at that point, but you're connected to the grid and using the grid when it's up.
How do I know, or how does a customer know if batteries are right for them?
I would say there's probably three main things to think about. What's the need?
Yeah.
You know, do you need just a short little bit of power because your electricity goes off for 15 minutes here and there? Or do you need a whole home backup for days at a time? So that's kind of the one big thing to think about. Secondly is budget. You know, do you have the budget to handle $25,000 all the way up to maybe $200,000 if it's a really, really large battery project? And then thirdly, what are some of the desired benefits? Beyond the need, do you just simply care that it's quieter than a generator, or that it'll reduce your carbon footprint? Or you just like the idea that I don't need to have a generator, I'm producing renewable energy? Or maybe another desired benefit could be that I don't want to have to get, you know, propane or something when the world's falling apart and I don't have access to fossil fuels.
If I'm out there thinking about possibly buying batteries and I've pondered all of these questions and I think it's right for me, what are some of the questions that I should be asking to a potential installer so that I know that my needs are met?
One of the things you want to come with is a list of loads that you want backed up.
Okay.
How often do you use those loads? What are the most critical loads? Maybe have them in order of most critical to least critical. And then also, how does the solar and battery system integrate with what I already have? Will the solar and the battery work together? Will the solar charge the battery? Is that for sure? What about the generator? You know, if I already have a generator, how will that work? How will it work if I have an EV charger? You know, how do all those things play together? Do I need load control? You know, those questions. How do all my systems integrate together, especially during a grid outage?
Yeah, that's an excellent point. And then for those who are thinking about whether or not I should install batteries now because I'm going solar, so maybe I should do it as a package, install the solar and the batteries, or potentially install the batteries further down the line.
So it's always most cost effective to do it all at once.
Yep.
One permit, you know, one site visit. You know, there's so many things that we can do once that we'd have to do twice if we install the solar now and batteries down the road. But if that's the direction that you need to go for various reasons, something to think about is, do I want to include the equipment now so that I'm battery ready in the future? So like, for example, I can install an inverter today that works with solar and batteries rather than installing a solar only inverter today and then having to take that out and reinstall another inverter down the road in the future. What I would say is this: if you're going to install batteries for sure in the next year to 2 years, go ahead, install that inverter right away. That's battery ready. If you're beyond 2 years with how quickly technology changes, you might want to consider not doing that, because in 2+3, 4, 5 years from now, you might not have batteries readily available that can work with your inverter that you installed.
What about some of the costs and some of the incentives for the different batteries?
So we already talked a little bit about, you know, your base cost is kind of that $20,000 to $25,000 range.
Yeah.
And then I would say additional batteries beyond that are probably in the $14,000 to $15,000 range. The largest systems that we've installed have around 12 batteries, and they're about $150,000, $160,000.
Yeah.
So those are the big ones. But then you have incentives. You have the 30% ITC, which is available for solar. That's also available, I believe, for all storage systems. We'll get some additional feedback from the IRS on that in the future, but that sounds like that's a go. And then there's some state incentives. Right now, Maryland has an income tax credit against your Maryland state income taxes. There's a few other states that are talking about some additional incentives, but that's pretty much it for now.
Yeah, so the ITC, or the federal tax credit, is on your federal taxes, and if you're in Maryland and you got a Maryland state grant for your batteries, that would offset your Maryland state taxes. So you need to have liability in both places
right,
in order to use it. How do I determine the size or the amount of batteries that I need?
So this is kind of tricky.
Yeah.
Because every homeowner has different loads that they use. And different homeowners value those different loads differently. Like, some might say my HVAC is really important. Some might say, you know what, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
So that's something we kind of have to weigh. One of the things we encourage is actually measure your loads.
Okay.
And we can put a device on your breaker panel on some of your main loads and measure that for you. Another thing you can do, if you know specific loads you want to cover, like a well pump or refrigerator, sometimes they'll have a placard on them which shows startup watts, running watts, or amps perhaps. And then if you can tell us about how many hours per day you want to use those loads, that's really helpful.
We have a calculator on our website, which we'll link below in the description, that'll help you figure out. You select your loads and how many hours a day for each of those loads, and it'll give you an idea of how many batteries and how many inverters, as well as the cost of the battery system for you and your specific loads. All right, Larry, let's talk about battery performance and how batteries degrade over time. What can you tell us?
Yeah, so one of the things to keep in mind is that your battery might hold 10 kilowatt hours today.
Yeah.
And 10 years from now, that might be 7 kilowatt hours.
Okay.
Typically, the battery warranty is going to have the degradation range. Oftentimes, the warranty will be between 10 and 12 years, and they'll guarantee that the system will still be able to hold about 70 to 80% of the original capacity. So it's about 2% per year. Battery degradation. That's about what you can figure on.
Larry, let's talk about now life expectancy. I know we talked a little bit about degradation, but at what point in the process, how many years down the line, is someone going to be expected to replace the batteries?
So most of our manufacturers have warranties of at least 10 years. 10
yep.
to 12 is typical. I hear battery manufacturers say things like they should last 15 years or 20 years. I don't know about 20, but I would certainly think 15 if they have a 10 to 12 year warranty.
Okay. And then what maintenance is involved with these lithium ion batteries?
There really should be little to no maintenance required. Nothing from the homeowner. Obviously, we would monitor the battery. The manufacturer would also monitor the battery through your internet connection and make sure that everything's stable.
So Larry, let's talk about where to put the batteries. Inside, outside, how much space do I need?
So they can be installed outside as long as they fall into the temperature range that the manufacturer requires for the warranty. Otherwise, you're out of a warranty.
Sure.
Ideally, they'd be installed inside in a temperate location, maybe like a garage or a basement could be a good place, out of the weather,
mm-hmm.
for sure out of the sun, even if they're going to be outside and in a place that's temperate. As far as space, one battery, one inverter is probably going to take about a 6 by 6 foot wall space. If you have multiple batteries, you're going to need more space than that. Some batteries can be installed on the floor.
Okay.
So you can get away from the need of having huge wall space if you have some floor space to work with for the batteries. But most times, small battery systems are going to be wall-mounted.
What are some of the suggested brands that we offer?
So there's three main ones right now. SolarEdge, yep. Enphase, and Franklin WH or Franklin Whole Home. And one of the big reasons is they're all manufacturers that have a track record in the industry.
So let's go through... Why do we pick each of those?
So there's a couple of things that we look at in a battery manufacturer. One is, like I mentioned, the track record.
Yeah.
Another, of course, is price. Are they going to be cost effective? Another is flexibility. You know, how big of a battery system can we do? Can we go really large if a customer wants to? Another item is, how do they integrate with other systems like an EV charger or load control or something like that? Will they integrate with those down the road? And that's one thing that all three of these manufacturers are either already have or are looking into, some of those integrations. Another big one is, they're all lithium ion batteries, which that's more power dense than some other technologies, which takes up less space in your wall, lasts longer, and then minimal to no maintenance, which is really nice for the homeowner. And then another big one is that you have the battery inverter, and then the backup interface unit that's all from the same manufacturer. So you're not sourcing the battery from here and the inverter from here. It's all one piece. And then additionally, SolarEdge and Enphase also make the solar inverter. So there you have a lot of things from one manufacturer.
Now let's talk about the warranties, and maybe let's go through each of them, the SolarEdge, the Enphase, as well as the Franklin WH batteries. Start with the SolarEdge warranty.
So the SolarEdge Energy Bank has a 10-year warranty, unlimited cycles, so it doesn't matter how many times you use it, which is pretty attractive. And their warranty says it'll be at least 70% of its original capacity at the end of those 10 years. Now, you have to keep the temperature of the battery within freezing, 32 degrees and 104 degrees, for at least 95% of the time to keep that warranty.
What about Enphase?
So Enphase also has a 10-year warranty, but they say you can't do more than 7,300 cycles. So it's either 10 years or 7,300 cycles, whichever comes first. But then their warranty is 80% of the original capacity. They also have a temperature requirement. It's pretty complex. It's maybe a little more stringent than SolarEdge's. I'm not going to go into all the details, but they do have a temperature requirement as well.
And then what about the Franklin whole home batteries?
So Franklin has the 12-year, which is pretty attractive, 70% of original capacity at 12 years, or 43 megawatt hours, whichever comes first, and that's the equivalent of about 3,161 full cycles. So it might be 12 years or it might be a lot less if you're using it a lot more. Temperature cannot exceed 77 degrees average annually and cannot exceed 140 degrees for more than 5% of the total warranty period. So they also have some temperature requirements there as well.
If you have a battery system that's not one of the three or one of the three that we mentioned, and there's some things that you love about it or that you don't like about it, leave a comment in the comments below. We'd love to hear about it. All right, Larry, so let's say batteries just aren't for me, or I don't have the space for batteries, I can't afford batteries, or you're just out of your mind, Larry, and I'm not going to spend $50,000 on a battery backup. What are my options?
So one option is just to be grid tied.
Yeah.
I mean, and just accept that your solar is going to stop producing when the grid goes down.
Right.
And be okay with that. You're not going to have any power when the grid goes down. The other option, which I think is a good option, is a generator. You know, if you're okay with the noise, you're okay with filling up your propane tank, just install a generator and go that route.
So don't forget, if you want to size out batteries for yourself, go to our battery calculator on our webpage, which again, we've linked in the description below, and you can figure out exactly what batteries would look like for you. We hope you found this valuable, and thanks for watching.